Study of order Lepidoptera. Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about order Lepidoptera. Totally, 1 million species of insects have been described from different parts of the world, out of which 1.56 lakh species, that is roughly 15.6%, are Lepidopteran insects. Similarly, out of 52,946 species of insects described in India, 15,000 species, that is 28.33% of insects, are Lepidopterans. The class Insecta includes some of the biggest insect orders, among which order Coleoptera, that is beetles and weevils, stands first, followed by order Lepidoptera, which includes the moths and butterflies. Lepidoptera includes butterflies and moths. Lepido means scales in Latin or Greek language. In this group of insects, the body, wings and appendages of adults are usually covered with large number of minute scales. Scales are the modification of macrotrachea. They come off very easily when handled. There is a considerable similarity in the morphological features of the adults. This has led to considerable difficulties in dividing this order into subgroups. Coming to the habit and habitat of Lepidopterans, moths and butterflies are mostly terrestrial insects found in all habitats except in oceans, Arctic and Antarctic regions of the globe. They are most abundant in tropical regions. Most Lepidopteran species are found on various parts of the plants, including the roots and seeds. A few species are found in the leaf litter and act as scavengers also. Only one subfamily of Pyralidae, that is Nymphulinae, has got aquatic larvae feeding on aquatic plants. Adult Lepidopterans usually live entirely on juices of flowers, overripe fruits, honeydew and other liquid substances. The larvae of moths and butterflies have well-developed biting mouth parts and are mostly herbivorous. Some moths and butterflies replenish their salt requirement by mud puddling. Some moths and butterflies also have eversible pheromone glands at the tip of their abdomen, and air pencils called corymata are common in males. Coming to the economic importance of Lepidopterans, economically Lepidopterans are of great importance in the larval stages as pests of several crop plants. Larvae are phytophagous, feeding on cultivated crops. Some are defoliators, shoot borers, leaf folders, leaf miners, root borers, cutworms, army worms, etc. Several species attack stored grains or products, fabrics, wool, carpets, dried vegetable matter, etc. A few moth species have also developed the ability to pierce the skin of animals and suck the blood. While some noctuid moth species can pierce the skin of fruits and suck the juices, thus causing serious economic loss to the fruit growers. The greater wax moth, Galleria melonella, is injurious to bee culture or apiculture industry. Several species of moths are predaceous and often become pests of lac insects, and some are beneficial as they feed on coccids. Example, Lycanidae, which includes Spalgis apias, and aphid predators, example under Pyralidae, which includes Dipha aphidivora, or parasitic Aucanorhynchae, example Epiropyridae, under which the predator Epirichenia melanoleuca exists. Few species such as silkworms are immensely beneficial to mankind. You are all aware that silkworm produces natural silk fiber, and these silkworms belong to the families of Bombycidae and Saturninidae. Moths and butterflies also act as important pollinators, models, and also as objects of entertainment. They are also most popular because of their attractive and brilliant coloration. The Lepidoptera are the beauty queens of the insect world, at least to the biased eye of humans. They are distinctive mainly because of their showy wings, which make them appear larger than they really are. Coming to collection and preservation of Lepidoptera, the adult Lepidopterans are fairly easy to collect, but difficult to mount and preserve. The specimens are to be handled with great care, as the scales are easily rubbed off and wings get broken. They can be collected with an insect collection hand net, preferably with a light meshed net, and the insect stunned or killed instantly to prevent damage to the wings. Moths can be collected at a light source, preferably UV or mercury vapor lamp. Spread the wings and pin them to preserve. Classification of Lepidoptera. Members of this Lepidopteran group, which are the fourth most diverse Holometabolous order, share several characteristics including scaly wings, adult mouthparts, sucking or vestigial, mandibulate in one family, large compound eyes and two ocelli. The larvae are terrestrial, a few aquatic exceptions, and phytophagous with 13 body segments and abdominal prolegs. Identifying Lepidoptera can be quite challenging. A few families are distinctive by their form, example Pteropholidae. Wing shape or appendages, example Nymphalidae with reduced forelegs. But many are small and key characters include difficult references to wing veins. To see these, one must sometimes use oblique or backlighting. The specific pattern of wing color can be used to key out species if a good pictorial key or reference collection is available and if the specimen is in good condition. All our local butterflies and many of the larger moths can be identified to species quite easily with manuals in the lab and by use of butterflies of Washington display in the BSA 2nd floor Hitchcock Hall, Washington, USA, where the reference collection of moths and butterflies exists. The categories of moth and butterfly are widely recognized, yet vaguely defined. Basically, the butterflies are specialized day-flying macro moths with some of their most distinguishing characters listed in subsequent part of this lecture. The fact that these categories are artificial and not phylogenetically meaningful is illustrated by Hesperidae, a family that displays aspects of both. Some of these distinguishing features are very weak and they are exceptions to most of the resulting characterizations even beyond the Hesperidae. Nevertheless, considering moth versus butterfly encourage us to examine the general biology and diversity of Lepidoptera. In the subsequent table, only the most conspicuous and locally important moth families are listed. There are dozens more families, most made up of small, difficult to identify species, many of which appear in black light catches, sweeping and malleized traps. The skippers and butterflies are divided into subfamilies as recognized by Pyle 2002. The lower level of taxonomy of butterflies is controversial. You are only responsible for knowing the families. In most of these, the various common names are more usefully applied to the subfamilies. Note that the Nymphalidae are the most diverse and are comprised of several general morphotypes. Amongst these, the fritillaries and checker spots are the most difficult to distinguish. Some of the Hesperinae and blues are also challenging. Important characteristic features of the order Lepidoptera. The body, wings and appendages are covered with broad scales. Wings are found in two pairs and they are membranous. Mouthparts are siphoning type. Mandibles are vestigial or non-functional. Suctorial type, proboscis formed by the hypertrophied elongate galeae of the maxilla. Both maxillary and labial palpi are present. Metamorphosis is complete in Lepidoptera. Larvae are erusiform, polypod with prolegs armed with crochets. Larval body is 13 segmented. There are 6 ocelli or simple eyes found on either side of the head. 3 pairs of legs are found on the thorax. Abdomen contains 3 to 6 segments. The 10th segment carries prolegs or abdominal legs in the larvae. At the base of the prolegs, a series of hook-like structures called crochets are present. Pupa is obtect type. It is formed either in cocoons formed of silk, debris or earthen shell or exposed. If pupa is exposed or naked, it is called as chrysalis, example butterfly pupae, which is attached to the leaf or twigs or plant parts by means of thread-like structure called as cremaster. Repugnatorial glands are common in larvae which produce disagreeable odor. In family Papilionidae, these glands are known as osmatoria, which are present on the first thoracic segment and produce distinct disagreeable odor when the larvae are attacked by predators. Many larvae obtain protection through special hairs present on the body, which are called urticating hairs. These hairs cause irritation either by mechanical action or by the secretion of poisonous substances by the poison secreting glands, which are present at the base of the urticating hairs. Wing coupling mechanisms in moths and butterflies. The first type is fibula, which is a small triangular lobe present at the base of the posterior part of the forewing, which overlaps on the costal margin of the hindwing. The second type is jugate. On the posterior end of the forewing, there are finger-like processes called as jugum, which overlaps on the hindwing. The third type is frenulate, wherein a large number of bristles are present on the anterior margin of the hindwing, which interlock with the bristles that are present on the cubital vein of forewing. The two wings of each side are maintained together, owing to the overlapping to a considerable extent. The hind wings are usually larger and cover a greater part of the forewing. Scales are modified setae. There are two kinds of scales. The first type is macrotrichia, which are large articulated hair-like structures and they are flattened in form. Similarly, the second type is nearly all colors form scales. Androconia are the scent scales. Here they are the outlets for scent glands. And secondly, the stigma are patches of androconia, either scattered or in stigma. Coming to the differentiation characters between moths and butterflies, moths are constituting nearly 85% of the order Lepidoptera, butterflies constitute 15%. The moth activity is usually nocturnal, butterfly activity is diurnal or during the daytime. The eggs are laid in batches in case of moths, whereas they are laid singly in butterflies. The antennal characters of moths are plumose, pectinate, thickened or filiform, whereas in butterflies the antenna is clubbed or knobbed. The pupal form is usually a cocoon in case of moths, which is made up of silk and sometimes from the last larval instar hairs, body hairs of the last larval instar. Whereas in butterflies, usually chrysalis, it is without any coveration and it is called a chrysalis. And the larval instar or skin is from the, it is usually found from the last larval skin. The body hairs are often found in both the cases, but it is more dense in moths and sparse in case of butterflies. Usually the colors of moths are dull, whereas butterflies are beautifully colored. Coming to life cycle of Lepidopteran insects, the complete metamorphosis is observed, wherein the adults lay eggs. Larvae or caterpillars heat, grow and molt. This stage is repeated varying number of times depending on the species until hormonal changes cause the larvae to pupate. Inside the pupal case, they change in form and color, exchange chewing mouthparts for sucking type and they develop the wings. The emerging adults look completely different from the larvae. Exception is only in case of male bagworms which pupate. Females spend their entire lives as caterpillars inside the bags. There are four stages in the life cycle of Lepidoptera, that is the adult moths or butterflies, from which we get the eggs. Eggs develop into larvae and larvae in turn go for pupation. From the pupa, again the adults will emerge. Coming to the adults, wings are scale-coated membranes, thus the name Lepidoptera or scale wing has originated. These scales are the dust-like particles that come off if the wings are touched. Some clear-wing moths have sections of their wings that lack scales. Winged adults have sucking mouthparts in the form of a long, slender tube which is coiled when not in use. Butterflies and skippers are usually active during the day, that is diurnal, and have clubbed or knobbed type of antenna. The tips of skippers are clubbed antenna or hooked, and their bodies are stout like a moth's body. Most of the moths are active at twilight or at the night. In other words, they are nocturnal and have feathery or thread-like antennae that lack a knob. Eggs of Lepidopterans are usually laid when the larval food is available in plenty. Eggs will be either laid singly or in groups. In case of moths, they are laid in groups. In case of butterflies, the eggs are laid singly. Coming to larvae, all the larvae are erusiform and they are usually called as caterpillars. None of them have wings or wing buds. They have three pairs of true legs, which may be hair-like, and most have clearly discernible prolegs. Prolegs are nothing but the abdominal legs, thickened protuberances along their abdomens that help them to move. Thus, they are called abdominal or prolegs. In addition to that, they have a pair of claspers at the tail end. The prolegs are in pairs of 2 to 5, with the claspers at the tail end always counting as a pair. However, more than 6 pairs of prolegs are found in sawfly, which belongs to the order Hymenoptera. Erusiform or caterpillar-like larvae, both Lepidoptera, that is butterflies, skippers and moths, and Hymenoptera, which comes under the suborder Symphyla or sawflies, have erusiform larvae. The easiest way to tell the difference between the two is the eyes and the number of prolegs. Anal claspers are always count as a pair of prolegs. The difference is important because not all pesticides work against both the groups. For example, Bacillus thuringiensis or BT variety Kurstaki, a commonly used caterpillar killer or insecticide, is only effective against Lepidoptera, and it has no effect on Hymenoptera vis-a-vis the sawfly. An introduction to identification of caterpillars. Caterpillar morphology. Larvae of Lepidoptera generally have a distinct sclerotized head with chewing mouth parts. They usually have short, three-segmented antenna arising adjacent to the base of the mandibles, and 6 stemmate or simple eyes arranged in a semicircle adjacent to the antennal sockets. The caterpillar's thorax consists of 3 segments, which are usually abbreviated in identification taxonomic keys as T1 or prothorax, T2 is nothing but mesothorax, T3 is metathorax, and some of the authors also use these to differentiate between the 3 thoracic segments. Each of the 3 typical segments has a pair of sclerotized legs that follow the standard insecton leg plan and end in claws. Abdomen in Lepidoptera is usually divided into 10 segments. They are denoted from A1 to A10. A1 indicates the first abdominal segment, A10 indicates the 10th and the last abdominal segment. A pair of spiracles, that is the respiratory organ, also appear on the segments A1 to A8, A3 to A6 and A10. Usually, each bear a pair of prolegs, muscled outgrowths of the body wall that function as legs in locomotion and stabilization. Exceptions to the arrangements of prolegs are important in the identification of families and other groups. Caterpillar prolegs consists of 2 basic parts, a base which usually has got hairs or setae, and a distal planta which never bears setae and which usually carries crochets. Sclerotized hook-like structures arranged in rows or circles are usually called as crochets. Although there is much variation in the proleg, base and planta, figure 2 represents the same. Coming to the diagnostic characters, arrangement of crochets is a key character in caterpillar identification. If all the crochets in a circle or row are the same length, they are uniordinal. 2 alternating lengths are termed as biordinal, and 3 sets of 3 are called as triordinal. A meso series consists of a single longitudinal row of crochets and is characteristic of most leaf feeders. If the crochets in a meso series are alike in size and structure throughout, they are homoideous. When they are abruptly shorter at the ends, they are called as heteroideous. Other example of crochet arrangements and terminology are illustrated in the figure 3. Arrangement of setae is another significant caterpillar taxonomic character with which we can distinguish between the families and species. Setae are usually simple, that is air-like, but in some taxa they are plumose, knobbed, spine-like or spatulate. Spatulate in the sense they are flat, rounded and broad at the tip, narrow at the base. Terms associated with setal basis and the other features of the cuticle are illustrated in the figure 4, and they include pinnaculum, which is a sclerotized area around the base of one or more setae. Chalaza is a sclerotized projection bearing one seta. Scolus is a sclerotized projection bearing more than one seta. Vericule is a flat disc-like area bearing parallel setae. Vericuae is a fleshy lobe or convex disc bearing divergent setae. Air pencils, these are narrow clusters of long setae. Spinules, these are minute cuticular spines. Annulets, these are dorsal subdivisions formed by creases in the integument. Setal maps are stylized diagrams showing the relative positions and sizes of the setae and other structures on the left side of the thorax and abdomen. Each segment is shown as a rectangle, representing the area between the mid-dorsal and mid-ventral lines as a flattened surface. Because some segments are virtually identical, setal maps when used are customarily drawn for T1, that is thorax first segment, T2, that is second segment of thorax, A1 or first abdominal segment, A3, that is third abdominal segment, or A6, which is the sixth abdominal segment, and likewise A7 to A10. As with butterfly wing veins, a number of systems for naming the setae have been proposed. Some illustrations have been provided which give the setal maps that use a system of setal nomenclature designed by Inton in 1946 and now widely adopted by insect taxonomists. Coming to the pupae, all lepidopterans have a pupal stage during which the adults or the winged forms will develop. The pupa of butterflies is called a chrysalis. Most moths pupate in a naked pupa combined with other materials. Pupa are within a silken cocoon that is sometimes combined with other materials. Beneficial or benign aspects. Adults have got siphoning mouthparts. They sip nectar only from the flowers and are beneficial pollinators. Although the larvae have a chewing mouthparts, the damage from many species is insignificant. Coming to the damage inflicted by the larva, damage by Lepidoptera. Larvae have chewing mouthparts and are responsible for all the damage to plants. Although the damage from many species may be inconsequential, they may chew leaves, they may defoliate plants, they may bore into the buds, fruits, stem, wood and the roots. Coming to classification of Lepidoptera, number 1, based on the type of wing venation, that is suborder Omoneura or Jugate. Here the venation is similar in both the wings. Number 2, suborder Heteroneura or frenate type. Here the venation is not similar in both the wings. Second classification, that is based on the size of the insects, under which number 1, suborder Microlepidoptera, where the wingspan is less than 15 mm in size. Number 2, suborder Macrolepidoptera, where the wingspan is more than 15 mm in size. The third type or recent type of classification of Lepidoptera, wherein the order is divided into 5 suborders, which is number 1, suborder Zegulaptera. Zegulaptera includes moths with mandibulate mouth parts. Galea, which forms the proboscis, is reduced. Venation is similar in both forewings and hindwings. Wing coupling is by fibula. Larvae have 8 pairs of legs. Each leg carries a single claw. The second suborder is Dactyonypha, wherein the venation is similar in both forewings and hindwings. Females have well-developed oviposter with single genital opening. Pupae have mandibles with which they chew the cocoon and come out as moths. Most of the larvae are leaf miners. The third suborder is Exoporia, wherein there is no coiled proboscis. Mandibles and maxillae are present. Large wingspan of 25 to 100 millimeters. Similar venation on front wing and hind wings. Legs without tibial spurs. They are usually called as swifts. The fourth suborder is Monotrysia. Here the wing venation is dissimilar between forewing and hindwing. Wing coupling is frenate type. In forewing, the radial sector is branched but not in hindwing. Females have single genital opening. The fifth suborder is Ditrysia, wherein the insects are very small or they may be very large. Venations are reduced in hindwing or both the wings. In forewing, the radial sector is branched but not in the hindwings. Wing coupling is either frenate or complexiform type. Females with two genital openings. The ostium or bursae on sternum number 8, which is the copulatory pore, and the genital aperture on sternum 9 to 10, which is called gonopore, which facilitates egg laying. Coming to the fourth or the type, that is artificial groups, this classification is most popular of late. The first one is artificial group Rophalocera or butterflies. Their antenna are clubbed, wings held vertically to the body at rest. They are diurnal in habit. They are brilliantly colored. Body is long and slender. Examples, butterfly. The second artificial group is Heterocera or moths. Antenna is variable but not clubbed. Wings are held horizontally or roof-like over the body at rest. They are nocturnal in habit, dull colored, body is strong and robust. Example, moths. Rophalocera are butterflies, under which family 1 is Nymphalidae, brush-footed butterflies. Front legs are greatly reduced without claws. Hind wings entire at anal end. The tibia is short and clothed with long hairs, hence they are called brush-foot butterflies. Subfamily Satyrinae under this includes the paddy butterfly. Subfamily Nymphanillae includes the mango butterfly. Subfamily Danaeinae includes milkweed butterfly. The family number 2, that is Lycanidae, which includes blues, coppers and hairstreak butterflies. They are small to moderate sized butterflies with base of the antenna and eyes margined by white scales. Upper surface of the wings are metallic blue or coppery, dark brown or orange. Underside of more somber with dark centered high spot and with air like projection towards anal end on the hind wings. Larvae are slug like and may secrete honeydew like material that attracts ants. Some live in the ant nests. Front legs of males are usually reduced. The family number 3, that is Spiridae, which includes whites, sulfurs and orange tip butterflies. They are medium sized butterflies with white or yellow wings with black, red or orange marginal markings. Front legs are well developed, tarsal claws are bifid. Pupae have a single spine on the head and are suspended in an upright position. Example, cabbage butterfly. Family 4, that is Papilionidae or swallowtails. Hind wing with a tail like projection or prolongation, which is marginal extension of the region of the vein M5. Generally black and strikingly marked with shades of yellow, red, green or blue. Larvae are smooth with granular projection on the prothorax called as Osmotoria. Family number 5, that is Hesperidae or skipper butterflies or skippers. Antenna are clubbed with a curved tip. They derive their name from their erratic darting flight. Head about as wide or wider than thorax. Hind tibia usually with two pairs of spurs. Prothorax of larvae small and neck-like. The second suborder, that is Heterocera, which includes moths, under which family number 6, that is Cassidae or carpenter and leopard moths. These are characterized by medium to large heavy-bodied moths. wings usually spotted or mottled. Abdomen extend beyond the hind wings. Family 7, that is Eponomutidae, which includes diamondback moth or emerine moths. They are small moths, four wings usually brightly patterned, often with diamond shaped marks. Example, diamond-backed moth, Plutella xylostella, which is a serious pest of cabbage and cruciferous vegetables. Family number 8, that is Xylorhynchidae, which includes small to medium-sized moths with smooth, scaled head. Ocelli or simple eyes are usually absent. Hind leg tibia with long hair-like scales. The larvae feed on silken webs entangled with debris and frass. Family number 9, that is Gelichidae or Gelichid moths. They are small to minute moths. Forewing is narrowly rounded or pointed at the apex. Hindwing somewhat trapezoidal. Apex is prolonged. Palpae are upcurved, third segment long and tapering. Example, the groundnut leaf miner, Aprorima modicella. And pink bollworm, Pectinopora gossypiella, which is a serious pest of cotton. The 10th family includes Spiralidae or snout moths. They are small, delicate moths with labial palpi projecting forward into a snout-like structure. Their legs are long and slender. Example, Cirrhophaga insertulas, which is the paddy stem borer or rice stem borer, and brinjal shoot and fruit borer, scientifically called as Leucinodes arbonalis. Family number 11, that is Styroporidae or plume moths. Here, the moths are small, slender, and long-legged. Front wings, 2 to 4 lobed, hind wings are having 3 lobes. Family number 12, Saturninidae or giant silk moths. Medium to very huge moths with broad wings. Prenulum, small or vestigial. Wings usually with transparent eye spots. Larvae stout, provided with scoli and spin. Tough silken cocoon which yields commercial silk. Example, Samia cynthia ricini, that is the airy silk moth, and Actias seleni, the Indian moon moth, and Attacus atlas, the Indian atlas moth. These are big moths. Family number 13, which includes Bombycidae, which we are all familiar, which includes the mulberry silk moth, Bombyx mori. The morphological features of Bombycidae are, antenna is markedly pectinate, body covered with fine hairs, proboscis is absent, larvae glabrous and elongate, spin dense silken cocoons from which commercial silk fiber is extracted. Family number 14, which includes Spingidae or Sphinx or hawk moths. They are medium to large heavy bodied moths with wings which are relatively small. Antenna is thickened, somewhat spindle shaped apically. Proboscis and frenulum are strongly developed. Larvae are smooth with horn like process on the 8th abdominal segment. Example, the death headed moth Erz convolvuli. Family number 15, it includes tiger moths or Arctidae. These are small to medium sized moths, usually light colored, often brightly spotted or banded. Larvae are hairy, called as woolly bears. They resemble the bear. Example, Amsecta albistrica, which is a red-headed hairy caterpillar, often attacking oilseeds, vegetables, and a wide variety of crops. Family number 16, which includes Noctuidae, cutworms are the common name. Usually, they are robust-bodied moths with four wings cryptically colored and hind wings light colored. Labial palpae well developed and ocelli or simple eyes are absent. Example is the ragi pink stem borer, Sesamia inferens. Based on the information furnished on the topic entitled Study of the Order Lepidoptera in the above paragraphs, it can be concluded that based on the different morphological traits or characteristic features, the insects coming under order Lepidoptera have been subdivided into 16 families. Four major types of classification of Lepidopterans have been observed. They are, one, based on the type of wing venation. Second classification is based on the size of the insects. Third classification is based on the recent classification, wherein this order is subdivided into 5 suborders. The fourth division of Lepidoptera is done into two artificial groups, that is Rafalosaura, which includes butterflies, and Heterosaura, which includes the moths. Thank you.